Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. This is Brother Santosh. I praise and thank God for giving me this wonderful opportunity to talk to you about how we can be rebels for God. Kingdom rebels. That is the topic for today. Praise the Lord. See, when God delivered his people from Egypt, let us go to that verse. It is actually Exodus chapter 8 and verse 23. It says, I will put a division between my people and thy people. Tomorrow shall this sign be. So, actually in the original tongue, this division is represented by this word, ransom. There is a ransom which was paid, and that is why God says, I will put a division between your people and mine. There is a difference between Israelites and Egyptians. And you know, when you read the following verses from the Bible, we can clearly understand that there are several plagues which followed after this declaration. I think it is the flies, swarm of flies were the number one. There was no swarm of flies in Goshen, where the Israelites dwelt. And none of their cattle died, whereas Egyptians lost them like anything. There was no hail happened in Goshen, but again, Egyptians suffered from hail. And finally, there was a darkness which completely covered Egypt. But you know what? Goshen was part of Egypt, but there was light. You know, this is the kind of difference which God wants to show between his people and the rest of this world. You know, we have to understand one thing very clearly, that we don't belong to this system of this world. We don't belong to this system. We are not subject to this worldly system. You know what is a subject? Subject is someone who has completely given himself. And we are not subject to this world system. You know, economy around the world is in a boil. Everywhere there is problem. And I read the other day, in Venezuela, people are eating their cats because they don't have anything else to eat. Just remember the kind of economic problem they're going on. I mean, those people are going on. So, but even in that case, it doesn't affect a child of God in the name of Jesus. Yes. And, you know, the world has a system of its own. You know, this world is controlled by lack, shortage, poverty, and disease. And you know what? We as children of God, we rebel that in the name of Jesus. We are God's rebels. We are kingdom rebels. And we refuse to entertain lack. We could come totally against shortage. We are totally against poverty. And we are 100% against the diseases. Because all of this belongs to this world. So, I mean, how can we boldly say, you know, living in this world and saying that I don't, you know, belong to this system? You know, what gives me that kind of boldness? Some may call it arrogance, but you know, because you know, it is not empty braggadocio or anything like that. It is based on the word of God, the unfailing word of God. Dearly beloved, you know, in Psalms 27, from verses 1 to 6, David is talking about the kind of protection he has, and he is making a very important statement. Let me read it from verse 5. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock. See, we are totally protected in the time of trouble. Okay, and there is another psalm, which is Psalm 32, and when we read verse 7, the psalmist clearly says, thou art my hiding place, thou shalt preserve me from trouble. Hallelujah. And let me read one more verse, because this will seal the deal. This is from Psalm 31, verse 15. My times are in thy hands. The psalmist clearly says, my times are in thy hands, in thine hands. My time and your time, it is in God's hands. We are not left to the mercies of this world, but our time is in God's hand. Dearly beloved, from these words, we can clearly understand that even though we live in troubled times, you know, in terms of social unrest and all that troubles all over the world, we are safe because, number one, we don't belong to this world and we are kept in a very safe place. And we have to remember one thing very clearly. You know, I told you that we don't belong to this system of this world. So, you know, we don't have to be subject to the statistics which this world throws at us. The economy may be in shambles, job situation may be in trouble, and maybe some of you who are listening to this video or listening to this podcast may have a report from the doctor which is saying something terrible. Let me tell you, dear brother, dear sister, that is a report given by a doctor in this world. And let me tell you boldly, in the name of Jesus, you don't have to trust that report. It is not the final word. You know, there is a difference between facts and truth. Facts are subject to change, whereas truth will never change. So the fact may say that you may have a lump, you may have a malignant cancer or something like that, or you may have something growing, you know, some problem, one or the other. That is what the doctors say. But when you believe in Jesus Christ, when you believe in what he did on the cross and trust God, trust Jesus to deliver you, you know, tomorrow when you go to that same doctor and when you go through that same scan or CT or whatever it is, and the report will come like, you know, you have nothing. And I think only yesterday, I believe I read a testimony where a person was completely delivered of HIV. He was tested positive for HIV, and after prayers, you know, God delivered him, and now he has been declared HIV negative, which means he is totally healed of the disease. Is that even possible? Yes, because remember, brothers and sisters, Jesus is still in his throne. And you know what he says? I think St. Paul says, we are sitting at the right hand of God in the heavenly places. That is where we are. So that is why we can say that we don't belong to this world. We don't belong to, we are not subjects of this system. And you know what? Behind all this, the idea is, because we are not subject to this world, we belong to heaven, we are supposed to live a blessed life. Yes. Praise the Lord. You know, this is further confirmed by a prayer. And this prayer was prayed by Jesus Christ himself. Let us go to John. I am reading it from my cell phone today. Okay. John 17th chapter. And you know what? This chapter is a prayer where Jesus prays. And in the 9th verse, you know, we can see that I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me, for they are thine. Here, Jesus Christ is praying, and he is praying not for this world, but he is praying for you and me, for us. Okay? And when we go to the 14th verse, I have given them thy word, and the world hath hated them, because they are not of this world, even as I am not of this world. See, Jesus has clearly told us that we are not of this world. But, and in verse 15, we are seeing an interesting verse. I pray not that thou shouldest take them out of the world, but that thou shouldest keep them from the evil. You know, many Christians would love to go to heaven as soon as possible. But Jesus is praying here that God should not take them from this world, but keep them from the evil. Because this is a prayer by Jesus Christ for you and me, we can be sure that this prayer is answered, and we are kept from the evil. Not only that, we are going to be blessed by what he did on the cross, you know, so that we don't have to live a life according to this world, but a life which is blessed and abundant and overflowing and with, you know, lot of blessings. Yes, it is God's will for you and me to flourish in this world. That is why Jesus Christ, you know, he died for us. By his sufferings on the cross, you know, we are delivered from this poverty of this world. So, if you are, you know, in kind of a, if you are frightened about some kind of a report, you know, either it may be from your job or some medical report, or you may be worried about your kids or your, you know, family, anything like that, let me declare right now in the name of Jesus, you are totally kept from the evil in the name of Jesus.
whatever the report says, Lord will change that and He will give a complete deliverance in the name of Jesus. If you have not accepted Jesus Christ, you know, now is the right time, then the best time to do that. Just say, Lord Jesus, I accept you as my Lord and Savior, and I accept your protection from the evil world which is surrounding me. Thank you. You just say that, Lord Jesus, I accept you. And that is the best thing that can happen to you. So, please continue to stay with me. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and family. God willing, I will meet you tomorrow. Thank you. Bye.